My name is Hector Pinkney from the Dojo Community Project, based here in Handsworth for the last 40 odd years. Well, Dojo, it's about empowering people, enhancing them to find the beauty within themselves. Because if once they can find it in themselves, they can help others. And that is why with the Dojo logo, it's about an helping hand, helping somebody who's down and bringing them up so that they can find a way within. We offer them mentoring, sporting activities, karate, running, keep fit, about self-being, and going to school to learn the rule, going to college to gain more knowledge. Don't end up in prison, you'll be eating porridge. And that is what Dojo is about, the shelter, the unity, the strength. I run a running group,
right,
which is a free event for bringing unity to the community. That means anybody's coming into Handsworth and they don't know where they're going and they don't know what they're doing. When it comes to the physical side of it, they come and they hear that I've done this, so therefore. Mark Goff from Central TV, he's the one who's given me this title as Mr Handsworth, you know, because I had to take him on the run. I also take Adrian Goldberg on the walk of Handsworth to let him know that there is also an heritage of the local people that's here. It's just to come out and feel the beauty of the people of Handsworth. So you will get to know what the Handsworth is all about. It's going back in the early years, when I was younger, I arrived here in 1962. A place called Leonard Road, which is down there after Lozell's area of town. We've still got the family house, which is still after 50 years. This house is now still got the same heritage stuff that's still there. Everything that was there back in those days is still there right now. It is one of the houses that was open house to a lot of the people in Handsworth, coming from the Caribbean. I arrived from Jamaica, like I said, in 62 as a child. And when I arrived here back in the early years, I remember going to the shop across the road where everything here was white. It was all white. I remember Christmas time, how beautiful Handsworth was, when there were all the shops, John Collier's, Burton's, Woolworth's, it was all here, the market. I can remember my mother carrying me to trolley, pulling that little trolley and holding my hand and saying, come on, we're going up to Handsworth Market. Come on, we're going up to Woolworth's. And all the sweets, what was in Woolworth's back in the days, the beauty of walking down the aisles in Woolworth's. And you know what I mean? You could just go and get any sweets you want, you could have got it. It's like that Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, you know, you go in there and you just choose whatever you like. And it was great old days. I came when I was about 10, 11 years old.
So you must still remember it quite vividly.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, how did it seem, like your first impressions of the place?
Well, in 1962, I'm telling you, the snow and the fog,
right,
those were the days that got you. I've shown so much of Bruce Lee's movie over the years. And with the Asian movie, I met Amitabh Bachchan because I've done the security for him. I also done the security for Mandela coming into Handsworth, done the security for Muhammad Ali, by taking him down to my house. There's a documentary that's been made from people from Holland that came down and documentary about Muhammad Ali coming here. But the actual person who went to collect him from the airport was Eugene Coddington, who is another world-class karate fighter. And we had lots of people who was involved in the background, but I was down there at the Muhammad Ali Center. I was one of the last person to be there to teach the karate to the young people. And if you look at these two teeth here, I don't mind showing it to you. One of my own students knocked it out at the Muhammad Ali Center. So when I show people these two teeth, they say, how did that happen? I said, my student at the Muhammad Ali Center knocked it out. Amitabh Bachchan came, we brought the limousine down the road just across the year, Waver Hill Road. We parked further down the road before the park was built, because we had to get some easy access to get him out of the place if there was a problem. He came to open the lens across the road. So as we come up, we got him up to open the lens. We had some scaffolding outside the front of the library here, and because we're doing some refurbishing down on the building. Some of the little kids, you know, they got some tomatoes and some eggs. And you know what kids are like. Amitabh Bachchan came out.
You have a text message.
The boss is not coming. Yeah, so he came out. As he came out, the kids got tomatoes and eggs and threw it. So I had to get him, cover him up. rush him to the car, get him away quickly, you know what I mean? Handsworth, where is Handsworth? We said in Birmingham, it's the second biggest city in England. You know what I mean? And if it's the second biggest city, come along and see what we are made of down there in Handsworth, Birmingham. So when people do come, they do come in to see Mr. Handsworth, which they've given me this title now because I've received an MBE from the Queen. So therefore, my title now has represented the area for a mighty long time. When I received the MBE, I thought somebody was really joking at that time because I had a phone call to say, "Are you Hector?" I said, "Yes." They said, "Well, we're phoning from Her Majesty's palace or house or something to do with Her Majesty." And I'm saying, "The Queen? What Queen?" As if to say, I thought somebody was really bullshitting, you know, I'm thinking. And I said, they said, "No, we're phoning from the Queen's office. Somebody, we're representing the Queen. You've got an award from the Queen and you're going to have to be coming down to London and stuff like that." And then I didn't believe what they were saying. So then I says to my manager, "There's a phone call here. I don't know if somebody's joking or what, but can you take the phone call and then you can relate it back to me?" So I just continue with my work, and my manager took the call and said, "Well," she came back out. She said, "You might as well come in. You might as well sit down because it is true. You've been honored with an award from the Queen's." I had the opportunity to go down to Windsor Castle. I thought I was going to see the Queen, but she wasn't around at the time. Princess Anne was the one who done it for me. So the Queen was out in Australia at the time doing the Queen's business. So the daughter took over and took my spot. She said, "Well, congratulations, thank you very much for being here." I said, "Thank you very much for making me come here, because like it is, I wouldn't expect in a dream or to go and touch royal hands, you know what I mean?" And while I was there, I met lots of other people who said, "Well done, son," people who I never would have met in my lifetime, you know. These are actors and professional people. I'm just a simple man who lives a simple life, who lives a simple way, and that is how I carry myself.
Yeah.
Even when Prince Charles came with Lady Diana, you know, landing the helicopter down the bottom of the, you know, we've had the history. Now we need to have more history and more beauty of Handsworth so that more people can come from any part of the world. Now you can see Handsworth is now getting so diverse that we don't even know how diverse we are.
That's it, yeah.
So we need to open the doors and let them come in. Award, I'm a Chamberlain Award winner. I'm lots of award winners. So you see that little cabinet up there, it's got all the awards to say, "Hector, a pat on the back, well done." You might have seen the One Day movie. My nephew's in, yes, the One Day movie. My sister's in the One Day movie. I should have been in the One Day movie, but the One Day movie was the part of what they want to give to me was playing a pastor, and I did not want to play a pastor role, so I gave it to the original pastor, which is Pastor Webley. So the role that was given to Pastor Webley was my role. The old senior citizen lady there, they're part of my exercise group, Monica. So Monica is part of the history. We're trying to tell the young people there is better things to do than to cause problems. Our parents came, they pulled a power press machine, they stamped the feet, they done all that stuff. So whenever they're talking about Handsworth, it's not about Afro-Caribbean and Asian fighting each other. People have always used that against us. That is not what it's about. We are not here to fight with nobody. My mother didn't bring me here to fight with anyone. Now you can say the world is in turmoil because of politics. If you were dealing with love, then they would have no problem. Because remember back in the 60s, flower power days, it was good old days, it was a free for all, everybody is happy.
Did flower power touch Handsworth?
I touched everywhere. Don't just keep on selling Handsworth as a riot place. If you keep on saying riots, and you keep on saying blacks are going to rob you, that's what you will get. They won't want to come. Well, the riots are caused to not understanding each other. Now, I've always remembered, the beauty of coming down Sower Road is at Christmas time. And I've campaigned for the lights to come back. They've given me a little bit of Christmas light back now. But really, we want Christmas light every year in Handsworth so that they're showing that Handsworth still can shine a light. That light has to be bright. I walked up to West Bromwich to a funeral last week, and I'm telling you, West Bromwich is, it's opening my eyes that there's changes opening, changes in West Bromwich. So I want some of those changes down here. Mm. I want the beauty to be shining on Handsworth again. Mm. Because you got two grammar schools in the area, you got the old historical buildings.
Yeah.
The carnival is really an Handsworth puller, but unless you can find that umbrella that brings everybody under that umbrella, it will always be seen and stereotyped as just black people thing. Mm. It's not a black people thing. Carnival is about everybody's thing. Just like the Gay Pride Parade, just like the Irish St. Patrick Parade, Handsworth can be bigger than, the carnival is a big thing. Bringing the beauty back to Handsworth, all these things have to be networked and brought back to how we can make it happen. My favorite building is watching this clock.
Right.
You know, so I've always tell anybody if they're coming into Handsworth, look for the clock.
Right.
You know, because this is called the A41 and we got two motorway links, which is the M5 and the M6, and you cannot say you don't know where Handsworth is, because A41, M6 and M5,
yeah,
that will get you into the heart of Handsworth, so you can find what the Hands is all about. But they have to come to feel and to touch and to know and to talk. Because if you don't do none of those things, you will never move forward in the game. The game of life is like Bruce Lee told me a long time ago. To be like water, my friend. You put water in a cup, it becomes a cup. You put water in a bottle, it becomes a bottle. So become water. And that's what I am. I am water. Because that's what the Grand Master told me. And welcome to Handsworth if you come in there.
Thank you.
It flowed like a butterfly and sting like a bee.